nhân dùng internet chỉ khi tin anh cha cho phong yên cho lên cho tu nên nó cũng phố van để bên mong tivi lúc chiều nọ nên chúng ta tỏ sai the phố van show olinda trong xe hai điện mà nọ nên đặc sĩ nên lúc chiều là sai bé thia mà nọ cũng mới tôi có chút sáng hay nên luôn bé hú hai tia câu li ya để cho nên tôi bảo câu li vì hai tia này giờ ít tiền mong và nên cú xe và tàu nhà hay nên tây li thì anh muốn tàu nhà chủ thì xử lý nên giờ ít co host nhớ là all that talk ở để cho nên tôi bảo bạn chú xí họ Facebook theo YouTube, ni yai tu blogger, ni yai tu board member, da ape lu kong ho tia, ni yai ilang nia, ilang tai, ni u ho lu, tia da shi na, ko sa su chia hai tia, ni ku la wai tu ku shong da tia, ko na yai ko wai zhong kong gao em ho na ku tu cha ni tu ku ta sa ni pon da, zhe ge shou, dan da na ma yai ko chen jing hei, chu sheng da bei ye ban ye mong, bu tou u bei tu chi zhe shong da, chi zhe ying da, de shi ma ji li tou bei tuan ya de chao na, bei ku mo jian chai mong, su li doctor dia cha go ka lia ya tia ta shna mo ja lo sha lo shon da su li moon va da bra ku tia ta shna go li ya lo ja lo wa lo shi li ja chu yi e lo lo sha te pon da re sha ren yang tia go sa ha de kho na ye ka jong kan go li ta pe ja hai mong tia e ti ya lin da mo na go ti li chang go li to na go jo ta sa ni pon da hai tia ya vi li ja ni ha ku shi lu ha sha de pon da na tia pon da na na ni nipon ni show hai dia all good things come to an end e wonder ko mali chang ko li dan ko tha thia ni mali pia to pe shara pa hai dia ya vi li cha ni ha show phone da de na e ole na tha ni shara ni ta ko sai tong ko li thia nya jong ko li mo na ko na ka nya jong thia
thank you
for having me so ko li mo na ka ton chi pe ka nya ka tu to a
Washington State.
Washington State, and you've been named Bolas Noli by Minnesota, not here? Okay. Yeah, so Kaolee, first of all, congratulations. Don't go pon da. I think that what the allow to see the deal out. I a big accomplishment. I go to a call out here. The she want the task of pon da. Yeah, go back here to the audience. Then I shy you idea. Go yelling to here.
I'm a co-host on All That Talk that I do with Kutupungyu Olivia Unaya. More COVID. And then, you know, we just have different people on, just like how you guys have your show here. Tantu, you know, everything from the murder suicides. We've had like Nahar come on. We've had other writers and like other business people on. So just people that we feel like would really empower the community and that other people want to hear. So that's what I do on the side as well. And then for work, I work in finance for Ilu Gonghao, Yahoo, Oregon. And so I do that as a regular job and then still do my things on the side. But as you mentioned, so this is the first book that I've written, and I'm hoping to write other books as well.
Yes, you know, that's so impressive. The guy that got to a very busy Kukungolitia, she's done in a guy yelling near Tia, got head of a idea. What is the inspiration behind the book? And why did you give it this title? All good things come to an end. So background.
Yeah, certainly. So I think it's a little bit depressing. I always say, like, I say all good things come to an end, so better things can come to be. Mm-hmm. And so the idea for the book was based off of just my own experience. So it's really based on that was very traumatic for me. And I think that your lifestyle completely changes. Whereas you used to have like couple friends, you used to have this, you know, like you learning, and I didn't really have anyone to talk to about that because all my friends we're married, right? And so I think it was a transition for them to to also be acquainted with the fact that now I'm different, you know, like, whereas, you know, before, like, you go to dinner together, or, you know, like, you have people over. But then once you get a divorce, like, all of that changes because you don't really have a partner anymore. And so I think when I was transitioning and trying to figure out, like, who I am as a person now, like, I don't have a husband. All my friends I had before, like, completely changes. And it was really hard. And then it was hard to talk to my family too, because of the stuff I was going through, trying to figure out, you know, how my life fits with everybody else's. And so I wrote a lot. My like ex-partner was my best friend, you know? And so because of that, like, like, what you're even going to say, because you're just so traumatized by the fact that you're going through that. And so I did try to, like, before I even wrote the book, I just really on, you know, social media, I would write my poems to really help myself process what was going on. And so I would just write and write and write. And it was pretty depressing. It was,
like when I was reading the book, very personal diary. Nhi chong ya li kut ka po diary sa na e ka ti li khi ka lu xia ka ti li hai cho ya ka sa ka chi jai li like you don't hide anything the good the bad and the ugly ka you mo show to ti shi na ya and gu ying sa ti sa hai te wow ka ye tun sam ho lo lo but you're so brave to just open your heart and share all your feelings with the world knowing that the stigma of sometimes you wali ka blog ko ka ho ka Facebook ka hai te yeah, like you just want to see like the whole community like shy to you and all the struggles that gonna go through and yeah. And even I read on page 53. I'm just gonna read a little passage that I really liked. Cause show idea. People say you upgraded. You left me, ugly old me, for something shiny, for something new, something that shines brighter than me, and I shrink to what people say. It's very powerful. It's very powerful.
That you reading that just like makes me feel all
gives
sorts
me
of
chills
way.
Too.
You know, I think like anybody who's going through it, like we don't talk about it because it's shameful or you're embarrassed. And I feel like it's so powerful when you share it because then you don't feel alone. And that's like the reason why I blog. And that's the reason why I wrote the book is because I don't want other people to like feel.
Yeah, also because go all the talk and then nung bao ga tia, you go sa hai tia, nung bao ga tia, you go hai dao shi hai tia. It's okay to not be perfect. It's okay to have all these feelings. And I yaw de nyali gujun no Michelle Obama and Shonu Pondona. Did they tell you sa hai tea or ya neng no lo jail lo moming mon holy jong the shil hamwa they not ten and I sa hai tea toko shot that no how does that make you feel? Do you feel better that you've expressed these feelings?
Yeah, I definitely do feel better. Like I think it was like my healing process. And it took me like writing this to like really, I think, get through what I got through. And just kind of going back to what you said, like a lot of people have reached out and just written me. And I think because, you know, I can share my experience. And again, it's really so that people don't feel alone, right? Because like, because it's not something that you just like openly talk about or like openly feel those things. And so I think for me, it's just like, it's okay for me to talk about it so that other people won't feel what I felt, because when I was going through it, I didn't know who to talk to about, you know? And so I did find a couple of friends, and that really helped me a lot, but because they had already gone through it, it's harder to connect because like they get over now y'all did like all they can say is like everything will be work out, but when you're going through it you don't feel like it's gonna work out, like you just feel like everything just is horrible and you're just never gonna get through it. So I really wanted to like talk about it while I was still working through it.
Yeah, ta all of your feelings do come through, and going showing you're a very good poet. Cause it's a explain hay got Lucia Salita, got Molly ja, all in the got itu ni shon da la. How long have you been writing?
Yeah, so I grew up reading a lot. I'm the only girl of eight kids. And so I didn't really have itu like binjao to like talk to. So I think I just ended up reading a lot. And through that I really learned how to love writing. And I've written poetry from a young age. Like I've entered like po you know poetry contests and things like that. And I think when you're around a lot of boys and they're very like rambunctious and very extroverted and loud, like I feel like you just kind of look inward and you do a lot more like self-reflection. And so I think because of that I just grew to like really love to like ying da ta shang da ta, like to express myself. And I think I mean I think just in the Hmong culture sometimes, right, like you have to take a lot of time to reflect because a lot of people have a lot of opinions, and as Ithu Tai Hmong, right, like it's I think you tend to have less of a voice. And so I think for me writing was like a way for me to like voice how I feel and have that space for me.
Yeah, well, you did a really good job. So you know, nearly to paper go pon dang ni na ya. Paper ka final product su. Pe tu po thon tu jong gon tu ta la sen a ya. Si si ma ka pe hai dia. Ko si si ha dei bo li cha sho pon dang na. Ta ka de ka chi sai ya do. Ka chi sai hai dia gu ka style o gu ya sho. Ai gu ya sho sho li cha. More about your pages. Yeah, do you share? Yeah, did you share what font to use? Then don't yeah, go ahead and you don't even bother copy pon na. I got a pay min chi sa ka journey. I got shop on the na ya.
Yeah, so Pandai, I think it was like, I mean, I would say probably like Beishong to Shaonaya. And it's not like you show every single day, but I think when I was just writing my poem, say, Mama Shao, Mama Shao. And then it was, let's see, last January was when I was seriously thinking, like, I'm going to take all my poems and write it into a book. For for my own memories too, and for my own healing process. And so I would say it really did take 3 years to even like shauna. And if you read the book, it's actually like there's a beginning, middle, and end. And it's all good things come to an end because it kind of goes through, like my that relationship now y'all, like meeting my ex and then the good parts and then eventually like how it kind of ended. And so like even that format, because I was trying to figure out like how I would even write, right? Do I just like delay show and then delay more randomly jazz a lot if I wanted to do a progression. And so at first I thought about like maybe all seasons, like fall, winter, summer, that type of thing. But then I decided that I think I wanted to showcase like just like again for my own memories to have like beginning, the middle, and then the ending of our relationship. And then that kind of goes with like all good things come to an end, and that is actually borrowed from a song. So there's this old song from the 90s by Nelly Furtado, and the title is the title of her song, and there's very significant meaning to that particular song that I won't explain here. But I did have a different title before and decided to change it. But like the illustration was from so I worked with Her name is Mai Jie Lau from My Folk. And she has her own company just making, like being a graphic designer and illustrator. And so she helped me quite a bit. And this is not the first version, iteration of the cover. So Tao'u decide on her cover. Now, yeah, I wanted to do, like, so if you look at the whole cover, like, of course, that's symbolic for, I mean, that is supposed to be me on the cover. And then there is the mountain range, and then, it's supposed to have a path. And it's really going through the mountains. Now, I'll tell you, like, for any traumatic experience I think that you have, or any hard challenge that you have, like, it does feel like and it's hard, and the terrain is not even, and getting through it is difficult. And I think for me, that's, like, the significance of the cover is that this was a journey that I had to go through, and sometimes it was up and sometimes it was down, and sometimes you're by yourself and sometimes you're with other people. And so selecting that, and then, I mean, even the color of, like, da blahao and da bang, like, it's funny that to, like, even Sansu, that we went into so much detail, but those did have a lot of significance. And then the illustrations in the book, working with her, of just like what I felt like the significance of those things would be. But you're absolutely correct that, like, yeah, they fawn lo yin sai, like where we put the numbering, lo yin sai, all of those things. I really wanted to make sure that I thought about those things instead of that, like, I wanted to have meaning, just kind of like, how I had the book of just like beginning, middle, and ending.
Yeah, because there's so many choices, like it's like show show like a regular book, it's like show polo po me, gu gan gu na de po ko po ya ta na de gu chi pa dia. Oh, this is a perfect size. Ta ka de mo po ko purse de go by the coffee shop, de go by tu na ya. De gu sa de all of these little details are so particular to go tian really showcase de ko ye lang tu tian ma gu sa de ka process so ko only no man che de jo tu ni nyo de shi pe po pon da sa na de be sa de oh ni yong yi sa na ya. De gu sa hai de nyali ka sai tu editor tu publisher tên là các PMG đó bây thế đó cái để bây cháu vào chỗ show luôn đó này nhở để bây bảo bây sao tên chơi show ta yếu chỉ lì lụa cho muốn lụa tao tao là xin lỗi nhà lì chả
Yeah, so I decided to self-publish just because it was my first book, and I'm never, I'm not like, my major is in literature, and so I decided to just self-publish so that I can actually just, like, it's like that thing where you tell they sound like, I just want to get it done, right? I just want to do it. I just want to do it so that I can say that I've been able to do it. And so I decided to do self-publish. And the company that I went through was actually one that Mai Zhenya, she recommended, because she actually used them before. And so the company was, like, pretty easy to work with. But Mai Zhe, like, she helped me a lot, because how you it's very particular. And so, like, it was like back and forth, back and forth, because I had hoped to, like, ship it, May 11th, which is my birthday. And then I didn't end up shipping it until September, because, like, we would do it, and then based on Baidu, that the printing company, and then they would come back and they would say, like, like the spine, like, needs to be a certain way, or the black color was not correct. It was very complicated, and I didn't really understand a lot of it. And so Queens, and, like, help me, like, can you figure this out so we can get it right? But I did go through, a printing company, and so I think that that makes it a lot easier compared to, like, if somebody wanted to print, or go the traditional route, which I would like to try that next time. I have an idea for a next book, and so the next time I want to go, go through a publishing company. But for this one, it was just self-publishing.
Yeah, so Jean Yali like you mommy you know yeah because Wow, congratulations, you know, you finally complete it upon the not ready to get your readers through now. How do you feel?
Green chai tao. Green and chai be that, like you said, it's like it, you like you just show and then you up by name and then you just feel so exposed, you know, like you just feel like almost like you're naked and people can see you.
Yes.
And so, I was definitely like when it was done, I was like, oh my gosh, like now I'm scared, you know, like I was scared before, but now I'm like really scared because now people are gonna read all these things and know all these things about me because I didn't want to hold back too, you know, like you said, I wanted it to be personal so that if somebody was going through it, let her feel connected. And yeah, because I think that when you go through something like yeah, you feel you healing by through go is very hard. But I think when you can feel like, oh, like that person knows how I'm feeling, Jejungo, it's you're more at peace and hopefully you can feel like I can get through it. And so I was really nervous to for people to read. And I'm sure people read it, especially like I think that they need to show you day, you teach maybe you teach your kids to actually the people that know you. It is very scary to feel like, oh, now you know all these things about me. But you know, I think again, I try to think about like the positive aspect of it, the hope that like, you know, somebody who is maybe going through it, is about to go through it, or is just coming out of it, that they can connect to it and that my embarrassment means less than somebody else's, like being able to heal possibly through it.
Yeah, I think you're so good with words. On page 66, I love this first line. I grieve a future that is no longer mine. As little girls growing up, we live happily ever after. So we're so stuck on that happily ever after. That you just said, you do plan your future. You do bỏ hay tiền những future trong cha lớn này nhở thì tất cả nó sẽ là của xã hay you're so good with words so thank you for sharing that.
Yeah, that, yeah.
In
I'm
just one
serious, like
line.
every time, which y'all, it is like almost like a wound, yeah, a little bit. But then a part of me also feels like I feel a lot better now. Again, I think because like it did take me 3 years, and I feel like it did take me 3 years to fully feel like, okay, like you said, you know, like it's just like all those plans in our heads, and then it just ends. And I think getting through that and you know realizing that it's okay. And so I do feel like in some ways like being like I think that you know jog the thinning or like lose a person, it does change you. But I do feel like it has changed me for the better of just like learning the to accept that things don't always, you know, go as planned. And, you know, even like, you know, all good things come to an end. So better things can come to be. And I just think you have to realize that and not hold on to the past and, you know, be able to move forward.
Yeah, you're so young and just to be so insightful and so wise and to share your heart with all of your viewers because there is such a gift. So
So you can find this on my website, which is just kaolee.com. So that's kaolee.com. And then Hmong ABC at I think it's Hmong Town, not Hmong Village, Hmong Town. They also carry the books. And then they are also at Sia Gallery off I can't remember what boulevard that is, but so Sia Gallery does carry it too. And then the Minnesota library system does carry the my books as well. And then hoping to get it onto Amazon, but like yo a team, you know, so you like it's just as much time as I can get, but I would like to get it onto Amazon and then and some other bookstores as well.
Yeah. So what advice do you have for people who want to write a book?
Just do it. That like Shalza, you know, I think when I was writing, I did take some time away to go write. So I did like, you know, like get out of here and like, you know, like go different places to write. Just because like I think it when sometimes you think Shonda, you yongi, you know, touch you to like sit there and be disciplined and to write. And it's actually quite hard. And you know, there's something that people call writer's block. Now, I'll tell you, you sound shallow, you shall shit, or the words don't come to you. So I would say, you know, like don't feel like it has to be perfect. Got to like be shallow, so like all the ideas in your head, because you will always go back and like edit it. You know, there's plenty of time for that. So if you want to write, just set aside time and be very disciplined. So you know, and thinking about writing my next book, like Winsada, I'm going to schedule a certain time and then I'm going to sit down and I'm just going to write, you know? So I think that that's really important to make sure that you're disciplined and you make time to just do the hard work. It's boring. Writing is not, you know, it's nice to like have a book, you know, to show, but writing is pretty boring. So it's okay that it's hard. Again, just the discipline and not having, you know, not being a perfectionist. I think that sometimes you produce a, you know, a piece of work and you want it to be like perfect. But the thing is, like, if you don't start, you're never going to have anything. And so I would say, you know, just write and you figure things out along the way.
Yeah, there's a quote by Toni Morrison, who's actually one of my favorite authors. Toni Morrison, Shonghai, if there's a book that you want to read, but it hasn't been written yet, then you must write it. She told me to show na. You got your to show na na ya. You talk a high to got your remind good to call quote then. It will not go leak on yet your author. To see who are your favorite authors?
So my favorite author is Brené Brown. So she is a she's been known as like a shame researcher. And so Lulu Shame. What is that in Hmong? I don't even know what it's not Zamul, y'all. Shame isn't Zamul, is it? I'm not sure if shame is the word shame means somewhat, but she is referred to as a shame researcher, and she gave a TED talk on, you know, what it means to like, you know, have shame. But I really like her writing because I feel like she gives words to help explain things, you know, and I think that's what is so great about authors, is that, you know, whether it's like if they write like, you know, nonfiction or fiction, I think they give you ideas and chuyi that is just in their head, right? And like you said, you know, if there's a book you want to, you know, read, write it. It's just because your ideas are so like unique to you, and each morning they talk about, you know, the same ideas. It's always going to be a little bit different. And so, for, you know, like for writing, I love Brené Brown and how she writes and how she just gives meaning to words and experiences. So I would say that that's probably, you know, one of my favorite writers.
Yeah, the good king. Personally, I'm so happy. The money just flow. What the shit? Don't watch you. You know, show down. I live by that. Go high. Job. Be more. Be job. But you mong. What? Show down. Sleep. Doctor. Dear. Chang. Go. Go. Learn. What? The show. So. They. Yeah. What? Be job. But you. Your mong. Go through. The show. So. They. Yeah. Learn. That. The shit. The show. Money. Just flow. You know. Social poetry. You know. Watch you. You. Yeah. Tian. I go. So. High. There. These are things that. Be job. But you mong. I'm just so proud of to see all of these accomplishments. So, Kaolee, what's next?
So I do want to oh yeah, and just kind of going back to that, like, so I was actually inspired by it was I think 2019. I'd gone to like HND, I think it's Hmong American Partnership that did hold the HND events. And so I had met a writer by the name of C, and she wrote more like New show, more like, I don't want to say it's children's books, but it's probably like middle schooler books. And so that was the first time that Gumchi, like Itumong writer, and she got like in person. And so I just remember being like super amazed. And then I also met another poet who was Hmong. And so that really, I'm just, like you said, I'm just really stunned and like amazed by how much, like, how many Hmong people are doing things. And I think when you they, I think that really does give you courage to feel like, okay, like, yeah, and so, I definitely want to see more people, continue to just go after things, because I think that that really inspires a lot of us. As it relates to like just what's next, so I do want to write a second book. I want to write something that is a little bit more fun and not so depressing again, because I think a lot of people feel like, oh my gosh, like this book is, the title is so depressing, but I have an idea for a next book, so that's what I want to continue to work on, and just like continue to like improve on my writing, and just use my imagination a little bit more with this next book, which I'm a little bit nervous about that, because I'm an accountant by trade, so like I'm not the most creative person, but for this next book, I want to like just kind of challenge myself and try to be a little bit creative.
No, that's wonderful. That's so exciting to hear. And just know that we're all excited to read it. So, could you show what you like? My daughter wants to know, how do you name a leader of finding love with charm? So, Olivia, Nick, what about the daughter? No, she's shy. So, the talk a little. Do you have that in the works?
We will have to, we had wanted to do Finding Love this year with like Ethan Bachelor and y'all. And then I mean we had gone and recorded it, and so we were super excited because just because I think everybody enjoyed watching it. And so we had planned to do that. It fell through, and so then we kind of just took a break just to like reassess, because Ging Shi, like the Finding Love in Shi Shi Ho, I mean, it was like a full-time job. It was very, very time-consuming, although it was a lot of fun. So we will definitely have to kind of assess and see, because yeah, it is a lot of fun, but also very time-consuming.
Yeah, it will in the goalie talk about you, Wahalu. Talk about you, a talk show, talk about you, Shondala. What things do you like to do? Can you order cheese?
So I like to probably hiking. I didn't do a lot of hiking this year, but there's like lots of hiking places, and so I really enjoy hiking. And then I've got two little kids, so I really like spending time with my kids and just playing and stuff. So that's kind of my de-stressor, because a lot of the times I do spend a lot of time like doing a lot of projects. So
Yeah, Songoli, thank you so much. Or chào rồi các lúc sau hai tia mà nó có tôi nó bên môn TV thả sau các phần tờ hoặc các show. Và lịch của hai cú. Personally, I've read the book. All good things come to an end. And the môn thì tia chua dạo và dòng sẽ sau thế nào này ạ. Để xem có lý hai tia. Giờ hai tia chua dạo dòng sẽ sau là. Còn nó dạo ý lúc ở trong. Và khi mà đồ dạo chia sứ. Thì tôi dạo dạo chia cho dòng cha dạo khu. Phần tờ nào mà có lý sau mà nữ dòng lý nữ. Khi anh lưu xia nữ. Khi anh hai tia nữ mò xia bộ cha. Nữ sẽ kênh bộ xua. Ở cha chỉ lý bỏ lỡ nữ đó chạy tê. Nó mà nữ xong tối dạo cơ ngồi lý thôi. Yêu nhìn mà yêu chú bóng cô mua thế. Yêu chú dòng lý yêu chú lý yêu trong. Có lý tốt cho nữ kênh tờ thế. Sau chân này ngoài lý chú xong tờ mà. Thôi yêu nhìn mà yêu yên cho cái lời nhỏ nữa. Ra just story đó nè. So thank you so much. Yêu đừng có lý bấm mua tới dạo anything that we haven't talked about. Tới dạo so thả cho phần tới nó là tới dạo có luôn nên that you would like to share.
Just thank you to everyone that's like bought a copy and read it, and for the I think it just sometimes like you can that like writing all these things and just like revealing so much, and I find a lot of joy in just feeling like I'm being able to like touch people's lives or for them to feel like they're not alone. And just, you know, all the positive comments on the book of just, you know, people really enjoying it. And so, yeah. And then I did have people, as part of just, you know, getting the book to the end too, it was, I had like, two people that, you know, helped me to edit the book as well. So I like before I even sent it to the illustrator and editor, I had Linda Tao from California, and then I also had Diana Ying from Minnesota read it just to go through it so that they can get their thoughts on it. So, you know, it wasn't just, you know, Guilin. Yeah, it's a lot of people, and then also just all my friends that really helped me to get through that time period too, because it was a really hard time for me. And I just had a lot of people that came into my life that helped me. And, you know, I think I hope that, you know, if anybody is going through it, or if you know someone that's going through it, that, you know, that you try to be there. And, you know, sometimes it's not like, you know, like, which was how I was like, but for me, the most meaningful thing was just to have people with me. So like, you know, like just checking on you, or just like, you know, hanging out with you, but not talking about it. You know, I think just having that and knowing that you feel very like alone, like you, you know, that still care for you. And so I think all of that really helped me to get through that time period. So I really hope and pray that, you know, again, being there for people, and even if they don't want to talk about it, just know that they appreciate it, because I know I certainly appreciated it.
Yeah, อยากก็เราจะเล่าเรายังไอ้สิให้เตียรุ่นดูเท่าเราตอนหน้าน่ะอยากจะอยู่มอเชียอยู่ที่ในป้องตะกมัวเจกุนเชงให้เตียตะกมัวก็จะแน่นๆเราโชว์เตียเลยเนาะเพียจะชดเป้าให้เตีย it's okay จะให้ดีมอสักกี่ยูเชียอยู่มอเตียชูชีเขาอยู่รุ่นหนึ่งว่าชีเขาเตียว่าอยู่สาให้เตียมูจะอยู่รุ่นเชียสานะอยู่เราโชว์เตียเราจะจะเกี่ยวกับ the writing is good medicine จะเกี่ยวกับ the ยังค่อยจงชัวปะค่อยลุเชียก็อยู่ดักลุเชียดักจงเอจะให้เดียวอยู่ลุเชียในจีจงเนี่ยกูเลยแล้วก็ให้เดียวยันเด็กคน last page ก็มวยเด็ดด้วยอ่ะชักเทียนเลยแล้วมึงย้อนแล้วยังเรามาปอดแต่ชิมวยเด็ดด้วยก็ตัวรูปเลยนะอย่าไอ้ตรงนี้เขา part หนูปลอดเท่านั้นอย่าอย่ากูสาให้เดียวไปเชื่อว่าหนึ่งย้อนเดียวเต้นนอทีไปย้อนชี้เดียวจงเรียนนอทีไอ้ว่าชอบให้เดียวก็อย่าให้ทุ่ม brave person you have a lot of courage that you're able to put your thoughts into words and to share with ไปเชื่อได้นะอย่ากูสาให้เดียวสุดยากก็อย่าต้องเต้นนอทีจงก็ไม่ชี้ให้อย่าชี้จงชันนะคะนอทีไอ้วันนั้นก็เลยกูไม่รู้สึกเหงา I'll give you a few minutes to give some closing remarks before we end the show
Yeah, thank you so much for, you know, just inviting me on here. And again, thank you for, you know, like just all the people that have been with me through my journey and like supporting me and helping me. And, you know, even like my parents, right? I think like, you know, like when I went through that, I was really nervous. I didn't know that what they were going to say, you know, and I've just been really surprised by how. You know, my mom is just like a cheerleader, you know, because like my brother had gone through something similar. And so I remember him just saying, you know, like, talk to mom. She's like such a good cheerleader. And so I think having like my parents, instead of them saying, like, I told you so. I think just having them like, you know, be there and support you know, just like be careful with how they have said stuff to me, you know, like instead of like making me feel down, they really uplifted me. And, you know, I just am so appreciative of that, because I think when you go through something hard, you know, like you already know all the sucky things that come with it. And so all you really need is like to be uplifted. And so, you know, I have been super appreciative of my parents and, yeah, just the community on, I have a Kaolee Gang page and just the community that, is being built there and all the people that show up, you know, every day for me. And, you know, I hope that I can, you know, be able to uplift people, because they have really uplifted me too. And, by their comments and their messages and, yeah, just absolutely grateful for people to even care about the book and to care about what I have to say. So thank you.
Yeah, Jean Kongoli continue to chase those dreams. We chase a Hmong dream, American dream, highly yalayatanta, and a yalone, yamachi, more pansu, yimitoshia, or more penyalanani, while I be a tone, there be a bane, it was Jean Kongoli, yeah, Ijonzi, had they got a bit more TV tats like upon the, and show how their all good things come to an end. But thank God he took a bay idea. Muyokatu, Nalaya name, Munchetala name of Facebook Messenger, and then Ron Coley Yang page, Languia Danish out there. And when I joined the Tiki, then I just shout out, Oligo Hai, Beijing Shia, Hai de Bimoja, Tai Lua, Walla, Kushia, Tello, Social Doshon Dada, Bishop and Yang Tia, Evelyn, the Wacho had them on a Tila Shai, Bimon TV, and Tongoli Yata, Evelyn, the Bia Bimon TV, and each those subscribed to Bainala, Tony was subscribed to Beta YouTube, theater on the Facebook, the Nathia, and it of Bimoti.
Thank you.